The modern city. With all this humanity, technology, and infrastructure crammed into a small space, it can be overwhelming. How do we navigate this ever-changing world to make our cities better, simpler, smarter? That's what Mauser and I wanted to find out. To help us explore where humanity's heading and the technologies driving us there, we've partnered with some like minds at Wired Brand Lab. I'm stopping by their office to talk to Michael Copeland. So Michael, I'm interested in finding out how technology can be used to transform the cities of the future, but honestly, I don't know where to start. What are the biggest issues facing the world today that technology could help alleviate?
The fundamental things are like transportation, how I eat, where's my food coming from, and where do I live, so shelter. Technology's taken on all those things, but now we have new technology and we have new answers. It starts with providing better information. If you think of a city or the world as a big system, how that system works. And then we can make better decisions on build here, don't build here, or here's what would happen if 10,000 more people moved into this neighborhood. Here are the implications for all kinds of things.
I think I've got a list of issues that I might be able to address.
What I think will really help, I have some companies you should meet, and it's going to take you around the world, and I mean that quite literally.
So I'm off. With the help of Mauser and some of their leading suppliers like Analog Devices, Intel, Microchip Technologies, and Molex. I'm traveling the world, exploring the ways people and companies are using innovative technologies and shaping smarter cities. My first stop is Porto, Portugal, where I'll take a closer look at a company looking to turn every vehicle on the road into a roving Wi-Fi hotspot.